Hi everyone, this is Shravan. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So this is regarding AFCAT, Air Force Common Admission Test Exam, so which is released by Indian Air Force. And this notification should expect per year 2 times, and this is the first notification for the academic year 2021, and second notification will expect May June month of 2021. And here the application will open on 1st December 2020 and close on 30th December 2020. Today applications are started. For selected peoples, the course is commencing in January 2022. The online applications are invited for the course commencing in January 2022 for grant of short service commission in flying branch and permanent commission and short service commission in ground duty, technical and non-technical branches. Online applications are also invited for grant of PC, SSC for NCC special entrance scheme for flying branch. Okay, branches and course number and vacancies. So here we have two types of vacancies. One is flying based, another one is ground duty based. Okay, again the ground duty classified into two types, and technical and non-technical, right? So for flying vacancies, we have total 69 vacancies which comes under short service commission. That means we have 10 to 14 years of service. And next, coming to ground duty, we have two types, technical and non-technical. For technical, we have total the vacancies here AEL, so aeronautical engineers from electronics branch. Okay, these posts are 27 and 40. So for permanent commission we have 27 vacancies, and from short service commission we have total 40 vacancies. Okay, so and next one comes to aeronautical engineers from mechanical stream. Okay, so here for permanent commission we have 12 vacancies, and for short service commission we have 17 vacancies. This is for ground duty technical. Okay, and next one comes to ground duty non-technical case. So in this we have admin positions that which comes under permanent category. So permanent commission, that is 12 vacancies. For short service commission we have 19 vacancies. Account section, so we have PC 6 vacancies, SSC 10 vacancies. LGS, we have PC 09 vacancies and SSC 14 vacancies. Okay, so when comes to NCC special entry, so this is available for only flying category. Okay, so here we have 10% of seats reserved for PC as well as SSC through AFCAT. Okay, so these are the number of vacancies for the academic year 2021. So here they mentioned about types of commissions here. So type of commission, PC for men. So candidate joining as PC officers would continue to serve till the age of superannuation as per their branch and rank. Retirement age, we can expect around 52 to 58. I don't know the exact figure. That means the candidate should continue their responsibilities up to that particular age. Okay, that means the age of superannuation as per their branch and rank. Okay, next one comes to this SSC for men and women category. So the engagement period for flying branch SSC officer, short service commission officer, is 14 years from the date of commissioning, non-extendable. So this is the complete flying branch. So 14 years of service, so after that they will get retired. Okay, and next one comes to this one, the initial tenure for SSC officers in ground duty. This is for only ground duty cadre, and in that ground duty tech and non-technical branches would be for a period of 10 years. Okay, this 10 years is the service, so an extension of 4 years may be granted subject to service requirements, availability of vacancies, willingness, suitability and merit. So primarily it is a 10 years of service. When it comes to flying branch, it is 14 years of service. So that is the short service commission. So after completion of these particular period, so the candidate will get retired, and they will benefited by the all government schemes. Okay, so and next when comes to age, so these are the age requirement for flying branch 20 to 24 years as in 1st January 2022, and next one years with dates also mentioned, and both rates are inclusive. And comes to ground duty technical and non-technical part, 20 to 26 years of age as of 1st January 2022. If you want exact date, visit this website for complete notification. And these are the physical measurements, so just you can go through full notification. Okay, that is better. And training, so training will commence in the first week of January 2022 for all courses at Air Force Academy Dundigal, Hyderabad. The duration of training for flying and ground duty technical, flying as well as ground duty technical branches, is 74 weeks. and that of ground duty non-technical branches is 52 weeks at Air Force training establishments. PAN card and account in SBI Nationalized Bank is mandatory at the time of joining Air Force Academy. Aadhaar card is mandatory for registration. So here the pay matrix is available, and 7th CPC level 10 pay matrix. So according to level 10, so the candidate will get around 56,100 is the basic and 177,500 is the grass. So net we can expect around 70 to 75,000. Okay, apart from this, they will get MSP 15,500. Okay, so flight cadet shall receive a fixed stipend of ₹56,100 per month during 1 year of training. Okay, so this is the pay matrix. And when comes to next part, that is the allowance. So here, in addition to pay, allowances are applicable based on the nature of duty, place of posting, and it includes flying, technical, field area, special compensatory, that means hill area, special force, Siachen, Iceland special duty, test pilots, and flight test engineer, and area and remote locality allowances. These are the available allowances in this Indian Air Force, right? And so when comes to leave spot, and 60 leaves per annum and 20 days casual and subject to service exigencies. Okay, and insurance, 1 crore insurance cover and contribution is applicable to serving officer, and additional cover of 12 lakhs and contribution is applicable to flying branch officer. This is only for 12 lakhs that is applicable for flying branch officer, which is not a part of ground duty. And sports and adventures, and just you can go through all these things, and tattoos are not applicable whoever want to join in this particular Air Force Academy, and narcotics, and just you can go through these instructions please. And conduct of online testing for AFCAD examination and fee structure. So this is ₹250 to pay this particular exam. This is non-refundable. And for whoever having NCC special entry, those people are not required to pay this particular fee. Candidates below 25 years of age must be unmarried at the time of commencement of the course. Widows, widowers and divorcees below 25 years of age are also not eligible. These are the some of the important things, just you can go through. And this is the physical condition. This is also very, very important. Just you can go through this particular section whoever want to take this admission test. And so this is short notification. So anyway, I will attach a full notification below of this particular video. Whoever want to choose the career in Indian Air Force, please go through that particular full notification. I will give 1 point regarding this short service commission. Okay, so this is complete 10 to 14 years of service. After completion of this 10 years or 14 years of service, again the people should try for some other government jobs also. For example, if one candidate joined at the age of 21 years in this particular short service commission service, so he will get retired at the age of 31 years, then he will comes under ex-serviceman cadre, then he acquired up to 5 to 10 years age relaxation. So he can appear some other government jobs including Indian Administrative Service also. Okay, that is one of the better opportunity for the students. For more update, please subscribe my channel. Please share this information with your friend, and please like the video. If you have any doubts regarding this notification, please comment on comment box. Thank you.